إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يقول الله تعالى أيضا في القرآن في سورة التوبة آية 119، الله says: بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. My dear brothers and sisters, today this topic will be about truthfulness. How a Muslim person should be truthful and trustworthy throughout his or her life. It is something which is very, very basic. It shouldn't be needed that we have to take it as a lecture and remind each other all the time. Of course, we should be reminding each other every single time and occasion and from time to time. But we should be remembering it. It should be in our hearts. It should be printed in our hearts. That is truthfulness. To be truthful. To be a person of truth. Who tells the truth? Who advises the truth? Who approaches someone in a true way? Who promises and be true to his promise? Who is making an appointment and never disappoints? My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. Oh, you who believe in Allah, the last day and his messengers, اتقوا الله, be conscious, be lawful, be truthful, be fearful to Allah. وكونوا مع الصادقين, and be with the truthful people. Be among the truthful people. Be a part of the truthful people and become a truthful person. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we should be ma'ah, with the truthful people. So that means you must be a truthful person in the first place. But if you are weak for one reason or another, then you have to train yourself. How can you train yourself to be a truthful person, and a person who always touches the point in a true way, not in a zigzag way, not from corner to corner, and not at blind line? So you should be with the truthful people, so that they train you, so that you learn from them, you adapt that behavior and change the behavior with whatever is opposite to that. If you were a man or a woman who used to keep saying whatever comes to your mind and keep lying and being and talking vainly, then this is the time you can change your life. And how can you change your life is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to you. Be with the truthful people. Kunum as-sadiqin. You people, those who feel that their faith is weak and they are not truthful, they should be with the truthful people. So in many other verses, Allah has ordered us, He ordained us, give us a strict commandment that we should be truthful. But I have taken this verse because it tells you the methodology, how you become a truthful. So to be a truthful is the basic to be a Muslim. And then even for your humanity, being a human being, being someone who interacts with the society, being someone who is reliable in the society, you must be a truthful person. A truthful person is the one who is successful in this life and hereafter. And the best example is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Take an example. Before he was sent as a messenger, before he received the revelation, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed him as a messenger, he was a man who was very famous in being truthful and trustworthy. His name, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his nickname was Sadiq al-Amin. He was the man who was truthful, the most truthful person in that society and the most trustworthy person in that society. So what happened, the culture before the revelation, Islamic wahi, what happened was that people, when they have conflict or when there's a kind of complex issue that they want to clarify, they used to come to him. Even though he was not the elder of the society, he was not the chief, he was not the police, he was not in charge of all that, but he was just a layman, normal person at that time. But then they used to come to him in order to solve their problem because he is trustworthy. If they go to other chiefs or so, they may have some interest in the discussion and they may side with one of the two sides, the plaintiff and the defender. They will go with one of them. But this man is a trustworthy and truthful. And when they went to their amana, their property, if they want to put it there, and then they want to save it, they didn't have treasure. So he was a treasure for them. Voluntarily, they would bring their properties to him and ask him, we deposited our stuff here, can you please watch guard it and we will get it later. When they come back, he will give it to them. So that was the culture of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even before the Islam. And when Islam came, Allah has ordered us to be truthful and trustworthy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us from falling into anything which is opposite of being truthful. That leads you to become a hypocrite person, to become a liar, to become a cheater, to become a scammer, to become someone who is destructive and corruptive person. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gave us this order, saying to us, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa kunu as-sadiqin. Oh, you who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be conscious to Allah and be among the truthful people. So that is what I advise myself and advise to you and advise to anybody else, to be a truthful person. Today in our societies we have this problem, specifically in the Muslim society, where we were supposed to be the role models of telling the truth, role models of being and fulfilling the appointments and the promises, but we zigzag. Another example, let's take Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are many examples, many ahadiths, many ayahs, but let's go back to the Quran and see the historical incidents of the Quran. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the previous prophets. The prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, most of them, Allah has praised them, and when in his praise, most of them were, the praise was about being truthful. If you read Surah Maryam, start from ayah number 41 all the way to 56, these ayahs, if you read, you will find the main context is all about being truthful. Allah tells us about Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he's saying, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَهِيمَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. Mention your book, your stories, your admonition, Prophet Ibrahim. إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. Indeed, he was a man of truth, a man who was famous in telling the truth and being truthful. So that truth, being truthful, Allah is saying he was the man who became famous in that. So that was his sign to be a man of truth. And وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا. And he was a messenger and at the same time a prophet. So that is Ibrahim. Allah discussed about Ibrahim a little bit and turned to the story of Musa alayhi salam. And Allah is telling us about Musa and saying, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّهُ كَانَ مُخْلَصًا وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا. Mention Musa in your book and your stories, and you will see he was a man who was honest, clean-hearted, and pure when he is giving conversation, when he is telling something, he was so honest and truthful. And he was a messenger and a prophet. Go down to the story. You will see the next is Prophet Ismail alayhi salam. Allah is saying, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا. Mention Ismail in your book, in the book, and in the storytelling, and in the admonition, in all the conversation. Remember and tell him. Tell about him. He was a man who was صادق الوعد. He never to break his promise. He used to fulfill the promise. He used to come to the appointment. He used to be truthful. And he was a messenger and prophet. So come to Prophet Idris. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the next verse, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِدْرِيسَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. And mention Idris. He was a man of truth. وَرَفَعْنَاهُ مَكَانًا عَلِيًّا. And then we elevated him to a higher level because he was a man of truth. So as a Muslim, you should be truthful and trustworthy throughout your life. It is unfortunate that we Muslims today, we handshake each other. We meet, say we hit in the market, and we hit each other there. We say, okay, we greet each other. We say, oh, so when shall we meet? Let's meet tomorrow there. We're going to meet tomorrow 10 o'clock in that place. So the person who is making that appointment, the one who is saying in the first place, he may know that he is lying. He is lying while intentionally and without any reason. And the one who was told, he knows that this man is lying too. that level. So we crossed the line of humanity. That means human beings should be understanding each other and making appointments, promises, compromise, all that. But if they are saying something and they are acting differently, and when they are saying they already know it's like, then we don't know what to say. How can you say that as a real human being? There's this disagreement. And this has begun here. It became a common culture for us, where our the basic issues in our Islam, one of them is that to be truthful. A truthful person is the successful person in all the aspects of life. So we are in this situation, it's unfortunate, and we can save ourselves very easily. How can we save ourselves? Usually, there are two things that can cause someone to lie. Only two things. And we don't know. Those two things, now we don't even have this, the problem of these two problems. But we still lie. These two problems are fear and anger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always recommend us to cover the needs of being, not to be in anger and in fear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in many verses in the Quran that he was telling us that the good things that he did to a certain nation or to all many people, that he saved them from anger and fear. الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who fed them from anger. وآمنهم من خوف. And he saved them from fear. So in any nation can be stable as long as there is no, these two problems are not there. So the third one, which covers these two, is just three things at the basic life for any human being, the basic things. Those are to cover their needs or that means to avoid or to make the nation or the individuals free from anger and free from fear and be justice. That nation can survive war. And any human being can apply that to him or herself. And today, who is in fear so that he or she can lie? And who is in hunger and who needs to eat? And the ultimate goal of these two is to save a life. The fear should be one which is danger to your life. If you just want to save your life, yes, that is you are saving life. The ultimate goal is saving of the life. Not even that you are afraid of injury or insult or imprisonment or all that, but the life. If you are in fear of your life, yes, that is reasonable. Because you are saving your life. Life is the most important thing. So the hunger, which you need to save your life. You don't eat that day because that if you are up to that situation, then you can eat even any unlawful things, haram things, dead bodies and anything you can eat so that you sustain your life. Then if it is causing death to you because of hunger, that is reasonable maybe your life. If the case is something which is leading to your death, then you are afraid you may lie. But without these two problems, if somebody is lying, we don't know what to say that. That is not even your own interest. It's not an interest of anybody. It's just that you are putting your life into jeopardy and destruction. My dear brothers and sisters, let's think twice. And whenever we are conversating, we have to avoid the words that we are not sure. the words which are leads us to life. And we should be strict to the truthful. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, we have to know the sources of life. We know the source of something which can cause you to fall into the problem of lying. That is, we said there are two things which are there, you can measure them, how they can lead you to death. If they are causing you to die, then you can lie. Those are anger and fear. But other things, there's no reason. That we are talking even the common sense. So being truthful is our life, is our interest. But then, what are the sources? What are the things that can bring us to life? Those things are, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, number one is that you say something that you are not sure. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. Allah is saying, O you who believe in Allah, إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. If someone brings news to you, and that person is unreliable, and he is fasiq, a transgressor, and فَتَبَيَّنُوا, verify the news. Today we are not in the stage of saying this person has been known to be a liar and so on and so. We assume that everybody is a liar now. We are in that level. So anybody who brings news to you, be he a sheikh or mullah or whatever he is, just verify what you hear from that person. Do not rely on the person that you know. That is where we are, because we have to be always, and we have to be acting according to our situation. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Kafa bil mar'i an yakthiba." Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Kafa bil mar'i ithman an yuhaddith bi kulli ma sabaqa." What is enough somebody to fall into sin? Is that he tells whatever he heard. Whatever you hear from somebody, you just tell. You don't care, you spread the news. And you don't know whether this is accurate or not. So that one, that is enough to be a sinner and to be alive. Therefore, that's number one. We have to avoid that and follow the instructions given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that verse, which is in Surah Al-Hujurat, and then this hadith. And when we see that, and the second is that something that you always say, somebody is talking, he said something, you say, oh yeah, I understand. Yeah, you already have your decision. You have taken your decision thinking that you already give description to this person saying, because you say that word, then you are such kind of things. Because of this, that's what you mean. So you have predestined a case in your mind. You have assumption. So that assumption and contemplation that you could content somebody to be a sort, that is real. That's a real source of being a criminal. That's what can lead you to be untruthful, to be a liar, and to be a criminal, and to be a sinner. So we avoid that also. And Prophet Muhammad in the Quran, you can see. And Allah says in Surah Al-Najm, if you read, إِنَّ الظَّنَّ لَا يُغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا. Just saying the thinking and assuming is not enough. and throughout the just also in Surah Al-Hijra, many surahs, you know, we mention, they are telling you do not act upon your own assumption, the assumption and estimation and thinking the way you are thinking. You have to verify everything. This here we can understand two things. That first you do not believe somebody, what somebody told you, and again you do not believe yourself what your mind tells you. Because there is a satanic influence which is always among the people. That you avoid always those things you think, the thinking and assumptions, everything must be accurate before you say and before you act upon. Otherwise, what happens is that if you adapt in saying whatever you have heard, very easily is that Prophet Muhammad says, somebody will keep lying until that person is written in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a liar. So he becomes a liar. He is known as a liar in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِيَّاكُمْ وَظَلَّمْ فَإِنَّ الظَّلُمْ أَكْذَرُ الْحَدِيثِ. So Allah is saying, avoid thinking, assumptions, and planning, thinking about something which is not accurate, because that is what takes you to become a liar. And that's what you should avoid. And to be a liar would lead you to become a munafiq, a hypocrite. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you find three things from somebody, then you just underline that person is a munafiq. These three categories are the ones that can make you to be described as a liar. Number one is that, إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبَ. If he is just chatting with the people in the conversation, he lies. He fabricates stories. He tells whatever comes into his mind. That is one. The other thing is that, وَإِذَا وَعَدَ خَالَفَ. If he takes a promise, he never fulfill that promise. He breaks his promises, and and if he disappoints in the promise, so if you make an appointment with him, rather he disappoints you. You ask him, then when shall we meet? When shall we talk about this issue? Tomorrow, that day, then never appears there, or says, I changed my mind. That is a sign of being munafiq. And in the conversation, he says whatever he wants, that's a sign of munafiq. He takes promise and breaks the promise, it's a sign of being munafiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this kind of munafiqness, hypocrites. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِيَّاكُمُ الْكِرْمُ فإن الكذب يهدي إلى الفجور والفجور يهدي إلى النار. I say to you, beware of lying. And if the liar lying will lead you to become a fajr, to be someone who is transgressor and sinner. And transgressing will lead you to hellfire. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from this tragedy, which is lying, saying whatever we want, and that are telling and talking nonsense. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the right path and make us human beings who benefit from their abilities and their words are counting to be resolved good. بعد الله شكرا أقوى الله عز وجل وأعذركم بنفسي ونفسكم بالمعرفة الله وإسلامي وآخر الصلاة.